Want to speak real Italian from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at ItalianPod101.com.
Hi guys, welcome to ItalianPod101.com. My name is Ilaria, nice to meet you, or nice to see you again. Today we're going to talk about the 10 phrases for surviving back to school. Something that when I used to go to school used to freak me out, you know. Of course, I mean, everyone loves holidays, so I was very scared, you know, I was a bit panicking for the beginning of a new year, really. All the time, you know, so it's quite normal, you know. So let's start our lesson. Zaino, backpack. Zaino, backpack. Vado a scuola con lo zaino in spalla. I go to school with a backpack. Compagno di classe, classmate. Compagno di classe, classmate. I miei compagni di classe a volte sono dispettosi. Sometimes my classmates are annoying. I used to love my classmates used to be my friends, but of course I had also some people quite annoying. But anyway, my best memories are from my school period are because of my classmates, really. So, compiti, homework. Compiti, homework. L'insegnante di matematica ci dà sempre molti compiti da fare a casa. The math teacher always gives us too much homework. So, homeworks as tests at school are a bit annoying as well. In a way, I mean, they're really useful, you know. You can also say in Italian, I compiti non mi piacciono, or non mi piace fare I compiti, which means I don't like to do my homework. Esame. Exam. Esame. Exam. Questo fine settimana ci prepariamo insieme per l'esame di latino. This weekend we'll prepare for the Latin exam together. I actually study Latin at school myself. It's a very interesting language, really. It's actually the base of the Italian language. The language itself, it's built in a completely different way than Italian. And also, if you study Latin, it's very useful for your logical reasoning. So yeah, it's very interesting. It's a very interesting language. Pausa estiva, summer break. Pausa estiva, summer break. Non voglio studiare tutti I giorni durante la pausa estiva. I don't want to study every day during the summer break. Okay, this is quite common. I mean, it's a bit like the homework thing. Even though you have spare time and things like that, I mean, you have to do your homework because it's part of your duties to be a student, really. Scuola. School. Scuola. School. Nella scuola dei miei sogni c'è spazio per tutti per studiare in biblioteca e in giardino. In my dream school, there's enough space for everybody to study in the library and outdoor. This is pretty much my dream also. I think that staying outside, you know, if you have like the possibility, you know, at your school, in your school, if you have like a piece of garden or things like that, it's very nice to get out, you know, and to teach your students or, you know, if you are a student, in a way you can ask your teacher for one time and you can experience the beauty of a lesson outside, you know, to make lessons, I mean, not just to play. I used to like this. I used to have a teacher like that when I was in my primary school, and I really like her, really. Studiare, to study. Studiare, to study. Ho deciso di studiare l'italiano come seconda lingua. I decided to study Italian as my second language. I'm very proud if you're doing so, really. I think that Italian is a very nice language. You can also say, sto imparando l'italiano, which means I am learning Italian. È il primo giorno di lezione. It's the first day of class. È il primo giorno di lezione. It's the first day of class. Siamo nella stessa classe. We are in the same class. Siamo nella stessa classe. We are in the same class. Qual è la tua specializzazione? What's your major? Qual è la tua specializzazione? What's your major? You can also say in Italian, in che cosa ti stai specializzando? Which is pretty much the same thing. And with this nice question, we actually reached the end of our lesson, guys. Thanks very much for listening. Please comment, subscribe, ask us any questions. We'll be so happy to answer to you. Thank you, and take care always. Bye-bye.